Hello, hello, everybody. It is 3:31 p.m. Central Time on the 4th of March, 2021. Hope you're doing well. You're probably doing better than I am and probably better than the people down in New Zealand. First of all, the internet's been off here at my location for a good part of the day. And you could call that chance or coincidence if you want. I'm not buying that. Let's get a display capture turned on. An 8.1 earthquake and other large activity struck down here next to New Zealand. Take a look at this. So first this morning, a 7-point-something earthquake struck right off the coast of New Zealand. And that, of course, made news. Everybody was talking about it this morning. That's when my internet took the dive. And you can see it again here. Let's turn down the rings ever so slightly. Again, struck off the northeast tip of New Zealand, felt across pretty much the whole northern part of the island and even a good part of the southern part of New Zealand. That's 7.3. Then we have a new earthquake that struck, 7.4 to 8.1. This 8.1, again, would be the largest earthquake to strike the entire planet in years' time. Struck at 1928 UTC, and that's about 2 hours ago, an hour and 45 minutes ago. This is a big one. This is the biggest earthquake we've had on the planet in years. And the location is directly on the plate boundary, which I can open up here and show you on the USGS plate boundary map, right here on the red line north of New Zealand. So it's extremely rare to get two different sevens in a day anywhere on the planet, let alone right next to each other, approximately 500 miles apart or so. So 500 miles apart moved on a 7.5, let's say, to 8.1 basis in the course of, let's say, 6 hours. A huge amount of movement. And this doesn't even cover the tsunami threat. So let's go look at the tsunami.gov, tsunami.gov. And there is certainly a tsunami advisory that's been issued, and we would even think maybe that we would get something even bigger than that. For instance, they've got 0.3 to 1 meter warning or watch going all the way over across the Pacific in Colombia up here, for instance. This is a big deal. Now, the better way to look at this would probably be to go to the NDBC, the National Data Buoy Center, and just see what buoys are in event mode right now, which I wouldn't be surprised if we've got a lot in event mode. And, well, I'm not surprised. We've got a lot in event mode propagating all the way over into, let's say, American Samoa to the northeast, as far south as the southwest tip of New Zealand, as far west as the Izu Ridge or just east of the Izu Ridge, and as far north as the Alaskan Aleutian Island chain. That's a lot of movement to see. That's the plate boundary that's shifting. And let me take you back over to the plate boundary map again just to show you one more time. Basically, going all the way down to here, going all the way over to here, and going all the way up here beyond to Alaska. This whole half of the Pacific has shifted on a 8.0 basis in the last few hours. Now, there's a tsunami threat. However, the wave doesn't appear to be that big, at least according to the warnings and advisories. 0.3 to 1 meter wave. I guess that is good news. But again, this is just something we have to watch and wait for ourselves, see if there's news that comes out on the areas around here. It's been 2 hours. This is traveling at the speed of a jetliner. The speed of a tsunami when it's out in the ocean can be going as fast as the speed of an airplane, so 400 to 600 miles an hour. Now, it's been 2 hours, so that means the wave could have spread 1,200 miles by that point, but I would think in the 8 range that we would not have a massive tsunami, not like the 9 range tsunami we had up in Japan. Now, speaking of Japan, this is the largest earthquake that we've had on the planet in years' time. We are coming up in less than 1 week, or actually exactly 1 week. 1 week from today, 7 days from today, is the 10-year anniversary of the Japan Mega-quake from March of 2011. So March is a time of year where we do see extremely large earthquakes take place. For some reason, we've seen this also happen in the summer and fall, and in the winter when it goes to the equinoxes and the spread of the seasons. It's very odd that this is happening right now at the time of the 10-year anniversary with Japan. But getting back to it, an 8.1, 7.4, I don't know if these are separate. Let's go see. 1741. Yeah, two different events. So let's actually go back in time. So at 1327, we have a 7.3. Then move forward several hours to 1741, and we have a 7.4. Then move forward to 1928 UTC, and you have your 8.1. So really, it went this, this, then this. That's three large earthquakes in a six-hour time period, not two. So I stand corrected from my previous statement that we had two. There were three, which is even more rare for that to happen, to have three different distinct large earthquakes 500 miles apart within a few hours of each other. Now, we do need to go back in time a little bit further to last 2 weeks. The last 2 weeks, just north of where all these big earthquakes are now happening, we had our deep earthquake activity take place, which are the earthquakes raised high off the globe. And you should be able to notice that the big earthquakes are sandwiched in between the two sets of deep earthquakes. This is a significant development in between them, but still nonetheless, it's happening between the deep earthquakes again. The sandwich point between the deep earthquakes, or the fulcrum point, the middle point. And we go back just a little bit before that, and there was a 6.1, six-ish earthquake, here north of Vanuatu. This is a lot to see in a 24-hour time period. Not just a lot, this is huge to see in a 24-hour time period. And we can go back several years to the last time this happened at this location. Go back to 2018. A deep 8.2 earthquake struck right here, but it was deep. It was down below the plates. That then caused a cascade effect to go all the way around the planet and back. That was 2 years ago, or almost 3 years ago in 2018. So if you're just now tuning in, an 8.1 earthquake, the first eight in years, struck, and my internet took the dive today. This morning, when the big earthquake hit down in New Zealand, all of a sudden, I'm magically off all day. This big earthquake hits 8.1. Within a few minutes of that, I'm back on. Somebody's screwing around. But we're not here to talk about that. We're here to talk about earthquakes, and you guys need to have an earthquake plan. I'll probably take the time to save this as a short video over on YouTube. But before we do that, you need to think about what you would do if you were in a large earthquake. Would you take shelter underneath a table or a desk? Do you have something to take shelter underneath? Do you have an emergency kit? Do you have an evacuation plan? Think about a tsunami plan, too. You need to think about those things and what you would do if a large earthquake hits. I'm not trying to lecture you. I'm just reminding you, please do that. Now, this big earthquake, people are probably wondering, did we issue a forecast for this? No, I haven't issued any forecast, really, for the whole planet, except for what was on the west coast of the United States. I've been dealing with a death in the family, a lot of other stuff, been being depressed, and I haven't been around. So, this was building. We saw this building with all the deep earthquakes, and the people in chat, as well as myself in chat, have been talking about it for the last 2 weeks, that we were going to go back up in the 8 range. And here we are. We are back at 8s. So, correct earthquake forecast hit, in general, looking for the 8, but, location-wise, I haven't been around for 2 weeks, guys. You know that. So, there it is. It's a huge quake, and it's the only good thing about it is that it's out in the ocean in the Kermadec Islands. Now, yes, there are people that live in the Kermadec Islands, but way less than, let's say, if it were to strike down here at the plate boundary next to Wellington. So that is the good news. Both sets of quakes, all three large quakes, striking out in the ocean and not causing major tsunami activity. Those are famous last words, not causing major tsunami activity. I'll just say, we don't have any reports of extremely huge tsunami activity yet. There may be some waves. I wouldn't be surprised if there were a few small tsunami waves, but it would be small, like they were saying in their projection. 0.5 meter to 1 meter, 3 feet. You might get a bigger wave in a storm. But we'll wait and see on that. The whole planet has been moving. A day and a half ago, Greece got hit with an upper 6.9 to 7.0 earthquake. They downgraded it to 6.3 if you go look it up now. But so first, it really started with this. And notice, two deep earthquakes, and sandwiched in between the deep earthquakes, raised high off the globe, that's where our big one is. Just like all the way over here, but it's just a much bigger series of events. It's wild. And when my internet takes a dive on a day like this, makes me wonder, makes me think there's a team of people either wearing camouflage, sitting there typing it all up and stopping me, or maybe a paid pet in the basement of his mother getting paid by some force to shut us down. I don't know what it is, but I'm sorry. I've been gone all day. Much love, guys, and I will be back. I will be back. We will do another update. I'm going to do several updates throughout the evening tonight, so you can count on me being here. I'll just keep jumping back on, keep doing the updates, okay? Everybody else, okay, you doing good? Everybody in chat? Are we stuck in any kind of viewing mode? Can you view in all stream resolutions? Are we stuck in 1080p? Don't answer that question. I'm going to upload this video over on YouTube so people can see it back, and we will jump back on at a moment's notice, okay? Peace out. I see we are stuck in 1080p. Isn't that wonderful? My goodness gracious. Okay, well, here. Sorry, guys. If you're watching on YouTube, you have no idea what I'm talking about. But if you're watching on Twitch, I'm sorry, guys. This is another way that limiting gets done. I have no control over that. That's just done to me by Twitch. I'm sorry, guys. Anyway, word up. Much love. I'm out of here. Peace out.